Hey guys, hope you guys are doing well. Wow, so some major changes taking place here in the LA market, and this also includes Orange County, so we're looking really at Southern California here. As far as I know, San Diego wasn't impacted and San Francisco wasn't impacted, but I can't say for certain. That's just what I've heard through the grapevine. Let me know if any of you guys in these other markets are experiencing the new minimum price increases on your listings. Now, a couple weeks ago, Turo had sent out an email letting the hosts know in the LA and Orange County market that the minimum pricings were going to be lifted on your cars based on market value, because one of the things that their data found was that in the LA market, cars were getting about 20% less on the day rates than they were in comparable markets. However, Turo was seeing 70% higher claims rate in the LA market. So, of course, what does that tell us is that Turo's risk is just way too high. And that has to be incredibly high if you look at the grand scheme of things, because LA is probably a huge market for them. They probably do a ton of transactions. It's a major hub. And so you can only imagine if they're having 70% higher claims rate in this market, that's probably pretty significant. And quite honestly, I'm a huge fan of this new change that they're bringing on. Earlier this year, probably back in January or February, I started talking about how the day rates have to go up. Prices in this market have to go up. We have to create that value in the market. And I'm definitely guilty of it too. I mean, when business was slow, I would totally cut my prices and get super competitive, right? And that, now I see in hindsight, really hurts the market. It definitely doesn't help in building the market. But you do it because in your mind you think like, well, you know, it's business and I gotta make transactions happen. So you attack the price instead of taking maybe the harder route of figuring out how do you offer more value to your guests who are renting your car and how do you provide a better experience. So I'm definitely guilty of it too. I stopped doing that a long time ago because I really want to help the market shift towards higher day rates. And I think another thing that a lot of people were really depending on is making margins off of some of the ancillaries. And in this business, what I've realized over the years is that your money cannot come from that because it is just far too great of a variable, and you can never really depend on that. Your margins have to come from the day rates. They just have to. There is no other option. It's the only way that it would work. In the long term, it's the only way that it would make the most sense to your bottom line. So, with that said, one of my biggest issues has always been the inconsistent experience that my guests have on the platform between hosts. So I've literally had so many times in the past where people rent for me, they have an amazing experience because I go above and beyond in making sure that my people are taken care of, that they're in great cars that are cleaned, well-maintained, and that it's just a flawless, seamless experience. Then they come back to the platform because they do have a good experience and they go rent from another host. And maybe that host is not as well versed on being on the platform and doesn't maybe know how to manage their car, or maybe they don't do it really full time. They're just trying to make some money on the side, whatever the case might be. So they deliver, you know, maybe a 3-star experience instead. Well, that taints the experience that that guest has, and the likelihood of them returning then begins to diminish. And so we start losing that client base on the platform because, as the host community, we're not able to provide a consistent experience across the board. And that is really, really frustrating. So one of the things that I think that this new price increase is going to be so good for is the retention in the marketplace. This is going to keep people because at the same time, it's going to push a lot of hosts out. Why? Because their cars aren't going to be worth the new higher minimum day rates that Turo is applying, right? So that's either because you didn't maintain your car, you haven't been taking care of it, it's just sort of worn down over the years, or whatever it might be, you're just not giving it enough TLC. And so when people rent that car, and if they're paying, you know, $130 to rent a 2 Series, which is the new price minimum on my 2 Series, it better be pristine and they better have a seamless experience, and it better be better than renting from any other car rental company, because you are paying quite a bit more for this experience, so it has to live up to the expectations that a guest might have. And I think because of that, eventually we are going to lose a lot of hosts, but it's actually going to be a positive thing for the marketplace, because the hosts that are on the marketplace and the ones that can get that day rate and serve that renter, well, they're the ones who are going to help really build this marketplace and add more value into it and create the repeat and referral business that is so crucial to the growth of any marketplace, especially during the slower seasons, right? During the slower seasons, like it kind of is right now because of the restrictions that we're experiencing, literally the people renting my cars are repeat renters. So that's when you really want to rely on that business and know that those people are going to come back and rent from you again and again because you provided a great experience. So we really have to build that base in the marketplace, because right now I think tourist attrition is probably not that great because of the inconsistent experiences that people have across the board. So we really have to streamline that. To maybe think about it in another way is, like, for example, Starbucks, right? You pay a premium to get a cup of coffee from Starbucks. But with that, you also have a certain level of expectation that you are getting a far superior product, or that your latte is going to be made a certain way, or that you have the option to get oat milk or almond milk or whatever it is that you drink, right? But imagine if you went to a different Starbucks that you're used to than what you're used to going to, and all of a sudden they don't know how to make your drink and you're not having the same experience and you're still paying that premium for that cup of coffee. Well, that would be really frustrating, and you would be less likely to go back to that brand and purchase that cup of coffee again. That is part of the reason why a franchise model is so successful, right? But they're successful because there's so much work that goes into streamlining the experience that you get, right? So if you go to one of these chains, like let's take McDonald's, for example. McDonald's is franchised, right? So that means you have multiple owners that own these restaurants, or really any of these fast foods. And you have different people that see business a different way. They operate in a different way. But these restaurants have built such a strong system that no matter where you go, you will almost always get a consistent experience, because the operators have to conduct their business within certain parameters, right? And there is a lot of scrutiny to that. There's a lot of ways that that's evaluated, and they have to really live up to those expectations. And that's why they continue to get that repeat and referral business. So when I look at Turo, I look at us hosts as we are franchisees, and Turo is a master franchisor. And as they continue to build out their system, it's going to really help streamline the experiences that our guests have when they rent from us. So doing something like increasing the minimum pricing on cars based on the values of the cars is, I think, very, very important. And for those of you that are not in the LA market, this is definitely something really important to pay attention to, because it could happen in your market as well. And so you need to be prepared for potential changes that might come down the pipeline later on that could affect you. So you really always want to think about the level of experience that you're providing. How does it measure up to some of the best hosts that are in your area? Are you on the same level playing field as them? Can you measure up to what they are doing? That's really how you should be comparing yourself, and you should always ask yourself every single day, how can I do this better? How can I offer more value? How can I justify the day rate that my guest is paying for my car? So you always want to think about that value add offering as much as possible. So really interesting changes. I have some notes here. I wanted to make sure that I wanted to share actually what some of my new minimum pricings were on some of my cars. And quite honestly, I was a little bit surprised to see how high they were. But I think the most important thing at the end of the day is, if Turo has the ability to acquire renters at that day rate, then we're golden, right? We can work on the experience. We can get better at maintaining our cars and just having Turo be what it's meant to be, right? Where people can rent the car and own the adventure. That's their tagline, so it makes sense. So for example, my 2018 6 Series, the new minimum day rate is $280. So that is the price floor. I cannot go below 280. My BMW X4 is 180. My 2017 C7 Corvette is 150. My 2020 C8 is 180, which is a little bit surprised, kind of low. And then my 2018 2 Series, $130. So a little bit high from what I thought it would be. But yeah, at the end of the day, we'll see how it goes. We'll see Turo's ability to acquire renters at that rate. One of the things that I liked in the email that they sent today is that they said that they will be monitoring the market really closely to make sure that it doesn't have an adverse effect. Today is Friday. The changes were actually supposed to go into effect on Monday, but I'm not exactly sure what happened, if there was an error or something, so they actually ended up going into effect today. I really wish that it actually would have happened on a Monday, because I notice whenever there are changes made to the platform, you know, as it is with any piece of technology, there usually tends to be glitches and bugs, and you know, sometimes things don't work exactly the way that they should. So I really wish this would have gone into effect on a Monday, would have given enough days to maybe work out some of the issues. But what I would say is just keep a really close eye on your listings, double check all of your settings and your pricing, and just make sure you're configured correctly. So we'll see how the weekend goes. I don't know yet. I haven't gotten any bookings since the new changes have gone into effect. So hopefully we're not seeing an adverse effect in the market, but at the same time, I think that I wouldn't be surprised if we did see an adverse effect. But only time will tell. And we are also going into a holiday week, so I'm really keeping my fingers crossed that it doesn't affect the holiday bookings, but we'll just have to see. So I will definitely continue to keep you guys posted on what happens with the pricing and the results that I see. And I'm optimistic. I think that it'll work out well. Perhaps they may need to make some adjustments and maybe reevaluate some of the pricings. I don't know, maybe not. We'll just have to see. So I'll keep you guys posted, but let me know if you're in the LA or Orange County area, and even if you're in any other market, what do you guys think about these new changes? What's your opinion on it? And how do you think it's going to affect the market? All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching. Once again, my name is Saima, and this is Saima's Experience. If you guys like this channel, be sure to subscribe. Thank you. Good night, guys.